back in our biology session. So in this today's biology session, we are going to discuss about the state board lesson. From the state board standard 5, we are going to see the lesson that is the interrelationship between living things. Also, together we are going to see the next lesson from the standard 5, and the name of the lesson is what? Environment balance. Okay? So as we know, in our surrounding there are the number of the plants and animals are present, and all these plants and animals are useful in a different way. Okay? So if we talk about the plants, there are the different plants are there, some are medicinal plants which help us to cure some diseases or to do the remedies for the diseases. Okay? Also there are the certain animals which are also very helpful. If we talk about the medicinal plant, then we can say that Ajulsa is there, aloe vera is there, all these are the medicinal plants which we can helpful for the cough. Also the aloe vera are having so many different uses which is very good for our skin, for our hair and etc. Okay? So all these are the plants are very useful. Plants also gives a shade in the sunlight. Okay? So all these are the different use that we are taking, or we are taking the utilization of the plant in these different ways. Okay? So being a human being, we are having the different needs. We need air, water, food, okay? And there are so many different needs that we are getting, or that all these other needs are getting fulfilled with the help of the nature. If we talk about the basic need, then the water, food and the clothes, all these are our basic needs. And as we know, the food is also we are getting from the nature, water is also getting from the nature, and the clothes that we wear, that also we are getting from the nature only. But along with these basic needs, the human beings also require the air, the human beings also require a different type of the facilities, okay? So all these are the different needs that can get fulfilled directly or indirectly with the help of the nature, okay? But see, all these animals or all these living organisms, their needs are the same, but the use of that needs or the quantities of that use of that needs are not different, okay? So if we will talk about the elephant and the ant, both are having more different in the shape and the size. So that shape and the size matters for their eating purpose also. So whatever the amount of the water drinks by the elephant, that much water will not drunk by the ant or other small animals. Okay? So we can say that the needs are the same, but to utilize that needs, to take the use of that needs is not the same. It is in a different quantity. So we can say that all the living organism requires the food, but the food is also different, that we have discussed in our some previous lesson. If we talk about the butterflies and the, what is the food of the butterfly? That is nectar. If we talk about the human being, then human beings are having a different types of the food material. If we talk about lion, then the lion is what? Carnivorous. They feed on that other animals. Okay? So in this way, the needs are the same, but the uses of that needs, or how they are taking that needs, how they are taking the advantage of needs is also what? Different. Also, next one we will discuss that according to their surrounding. Now, what is mean by the surrounding and what is mean by the environment? The area around us, it is called as what? Environment. Okay? So the surrounding and the condition in that surrounding which affects the living organisms. So that surrounding is called as what? Environment. That surrounding is called as what? Environment. So according to the different environment, the animals are living. So if we talk about the lion or if we talk about the tiger, mostly they are living in the region where it is having the very tall grass. Okay? So because of that, as you know, on the body of the tiger there are the streaks. Okay? And somehow their body is also brown. The color of the dry grass is also brown. Okay? So they can easily hide themselves into that green, into the grass, and they can easily catch their predators. So in this way, they can catch their food very easily, like a deer and other different animals. Okay? So the basically the tiger is living in the environment where there is a water, which is every time there is a water or the place which is near to the water, where there is having the very tall grass. Also if there is a mountain, if there is a cave, then in that region the tiger is preferred to live, because that environment is useful for the tiger to survive in that particular surrounding. Living and the non-living things both are depends on each other. There is a lot of give and take among the living and the non-living things. And the study of this interaction, it is called as what? Environmental study. Or we can say that environmental science study. Okay, so what is the interaction? We can say that. So see here, if we are having the animals, then the animals gives us what? Different types of the food, like that we can get the milk, meat, fish, eggs, honey. All these are the products that we can get from the animals. Also, we are domesticated some animals to help in the farming process, also to carry the loads from the one place to another place. Okay, so in this way, the animals feed us from the different things. Also, the plants also gives us the different thing. Plants gives us very important, that is what? Oxygen, which is very good, or without that oxygen, we cannot survive. But along with that oxygen, we are releasing the carbon dioxide, and that is used by the green plants for their process of photosynthesis. Okay, so in this way, there is an interaction between give and take processes there, which is very important for the environmental balance. Which is very important for the environmental balance, you can say. So basically, the plants and the animals give us different types of the sources which we are using. If we talk about the animals, okay, so that animals excreta are also very good for us. Sometimes in the villages, that excreta is used as a production of the fuel in the form of biogas. Also, it is used to cover the walls, which is made up of mud. Also, these excreta of the animals are good as a manure. In this way, the animals excreta is also useful. Along with the animals, the plants are also good for us. The plants are also provided the different things. As we know, whatever the food materials are there, that all the food materials comes from the animals. We can say the different cereals, fruits, all these are the food materials that we are getting from the plants. Okay? Not only the eating foods or the eating items the plants provide us, along with the food grains or along with the foods, the plants are also provided flowers that are also very precious for us. The flowers we can use in a different purposes. They are having some auspicious purpose. For auspicious purposes, we can use the flower. For the decoration, we can use the flower. So in this way, the flowers we can use in any type and any how. So not only the human beings, but also along with the human beings, the other living things are also getting their food from the environment only. If we talk about the squirrels, then the squirrels are eating the fruits. If we talk about the snakes, then the snakes are eating the frogs and all. Okay. So in this way, different animals are getting their food from the nature only. And as we know, there are certain animals who are spending their most of the lifespan on the plants. Then that animals are called as what? Arboreal animals. For example, we can say that monkey or the squirrels. Okay. So that monkeys and the squirrels are getting out the different fruits, and from the excreta, or while eating the fruits, some seeds fall down on the ground, and when that seeds are getting the favorable condition, they started to grow. So in this way, these animals indirectly helps to grow the number of the trees, that is the beneficial for the nature. Okay, which is the beneficial for the nature. Also, I will give you one more example, that the animals are, or the human beings, or the living organisms are depends on each other. Okay, if the buffalo is grazing in the grassy area, then the some birds are sitting over it. Why is it so? Because when the buffalo is eating the grass, okay, and in the grass there are the number of the insects are sitting in the grass, but because of so much rush of that grass, the birds cannot get that insect properly. But when the buffalo is eating the grass, she is going, or that buffalo is going inside the grass, and because of that movement of the grass, the all the insects are flying. Okay, so because of that insects are flying, that birds can easily catch that insects. Okay, so in this way, all the animals are depends on each other for their food or for their basic needs. Okay, for that purpose only, or for that important characteristic of the animals, we are calling them for food chain, like we already seen in our previous lesson. Okay, what is meant by the food chain? That the animals, for the being eaten, okay, to eat and being eaten, this is that process is called as what? Food chain. Okay, and who is coming in the food chain first? Green plants, because the green plants are the producers, and all the green plants, all these animals directly or indirectly depends for their use of the food. Okay, and if we talk about the environmental balance, then both the plants and the animals are very part of the surrounding or also the part of the environment. Okay, so these microorganisms play a vital role in to clean our earth. As we know, if there is a dead particles of the plants and animals, all these are get decomposed by the microorganisms and they are leaving all the important nutrients in the soil back. So when it goes into the soil, with the help of the soil, the plants again absorb that nutrients for their proper growth, and again the plants are giving the food and the different things that we are getting from the plants. Also from the nature we are getting the different types of the gases, and in that we can say that very important, that is what, oxygen, that released during the process of the photosynthesis. Also we said that water, from where we are getting the water, water also we are getting from the nature only with the help of the water cycle. So in this way there are so many more, all the things are there which are interacted among the nature and the human being and the plants and the animals also. Okay, so all these are the different living things are depends on each other for the environmental balance. We can say with the help of this environmental balance, for the proper environmental balance, there should be the proper interaction between the plants, animals and the human beings. Okay, so along with these plants and animals, they are giving us different things. There is a balance between the nature, okay. But along with all these things, there are the different changes happens in our surrounding. We are having a different seasons. We are having the summer season. Now it is the winter season is going on. After that, there is what summer season, and after that, there is what rainy season. Okay. So according to the season, we are wearing the different types of the clothes. Also, if there is a summer season, then we are wearing the cotton clothes. If there is a winter season, then we are going through the woolen clothes. And if there is a rainy season, then we are wearing the raincoats and we are using the umbrella. So according to the season, we are changing our lifestyle also. We are changing our food also. And that season is also very important for the fooding and the flowering of the plants. Okay. So during the winter season, most of the plants are shedding their leaves and again they are getting back the new leaves. And in the Kokand region, it is very important this winter season, because during this Kokand region, the mango plants started to blooming. Okay, they are having the blossoms over it, which is called as what? Mohar. In the Marathi, we are calling it what? Mohar. Okay, so this winter season is good for the development of the mango plants, and also some seasonal fruits are also there. Okay, also this winter season is good for the proper development also of the cashew nut plants. Okay. You can see the mohar on the cashew nut plants also. So this winter season is not only good for the plants, but with this winter season, along with this different season, the plants, the animals are also changing their body parts. So they are also trying to keep themselves safe from this different season. Okay. So as we know, the animals are having the fur on their body. With the help of that fur, they can protect from the very cold season, that is from the winter season. And after that, there we can say that the summer season is there, and we can also enjoy the different fruits, like we can enjoy the kalpanda, which are black in the color, jamun is there, jackfruit is there. Okay, so all these are the seasonal fruits that we are eating during the summer season. After the season, summer season, there is a rainy season, which is very good for the farmers. And during that season, the farmers are doing the so many different activities regarding the agriculture. They are sowing the seeds and they are growing the different crops. Also along with that, whenever there is a summer season, because of the heat of the summer season, so many seeds are getting dry and they fall down in the soil. And when it is a rainy season, it starts raining, then that seeds are getting the favorable condition. And we can say everywhere there is a green grass. Okay, now you understand how that grass is growing, because their seeds are already in the soil. And when the soil is getting, when the seeds are getting the favorable condition, then they started to grow and everywhere becomes the greenery. Okay. Sometimes during the rainy season, you can see the very nice rainbow also, which is made up of the seven colors. Okay. So in this way, the nature is a very beautiful. So many different things are present in the nature that we can utilize, and somehow we are also giving back some things to the nature. It is our duty to take care of our nature, to try to maintain the balance of our nature, that we can do, that we can avoid the use of the plastic, because of the plastic nowadays our nature is getting destroyed. Okay, so one should avoid the use of the plastic. One should avoid the, try to avoid the air pollution. If the distance is less, then you can walk, or you, once in a week you should avoid the use of the vehicles. Okay, so in this way, all our basics also we can balance. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed this lesson. So here we will stop.